I never settle on just one thing. And that, I think, is largely driven by this need to satisfy my curiosity. Curiosity is what allowed me to go beyond the context of the world that I already knew and then explore something else. I started my PhD journey at the St. Michael's Hospital right before the pandemic, and throughout the pandemic, I was actually volunteering at Toronto General Hospital, 3D printing face shields and doing design work, trying to optimize utilization of ventilators available at the hospital. And so through the volunteering work that I was so fortunate to be introduced to Dr. Yasufuku, and it instantly felt good. I also felt inspired because I could see myself contribute in a meaningful way. My name is Kate Kazlovich, and I'm a PhD candidate with the Yasufuku Research Lab. My research focus is on the design and development of surgical simulation tools. Essentially, it's a simulator that would allow us to collect a tiny little sample out of the lymph node in the lungs to determine whether or not the patient has cancer. And it's a really beneficial procedure because it's minimally invasive and it's quite fast, but there are no ways to really train how to perform it outside of the context of the operating room. So I've been working on developing a simulator that would allow trainees to train outside and to become experts before they even get to touch a patient.
So I am just checking my prints for visibility of the lymph nodes. I'm just looking at what it looks like under ultrasound. Right here, you can see little lymph nodes. And looks pretty good. I think I'm going to use this guy here to cast my first model.
This will significantly reduce the possibility of errors in the operating room and can improve the patient experience. And I think a lot of patients would want that. Personally, I would want that. I would want my physician to practice somewhere else before they get to practice in the OR.
So I just added the lymph nodes, like those little bubbles that you can see all around the model. And then my coworkers have tested it and then told me whether or not it feels realistic when they're like trying to sample it with a needle. And then sending it.
I came to Canada when I was 16 years old. My parents decided to immigrate from Belarus. I didn't speak the language, didn't know anybody. I didn't know how to go ask for milk at the grocery store. And I had to learn from scratch. So I really was just overwhelmed, you know? It felt like a lot at once. I will say I definitely felt depressed for a while. I felt like I didn't really belong. I couldn't really associate with anything that was going on. The reason I went into engineering is, well, largely because math and physics is something that you don't really need to know a whole lot of language to understand. I think at the time when I was graduating from the undergraduate school, I just thought of myself as a civil engineer. I didn't think of myself as somebody who can be creative, who can be a sort of an artist and engineer, maybe somebody who could work in medical science research. But then I asked questions and I got encouraged by people to see how far I can push myself, and I think this has been some of the best decisions I've made in my life. Curiosity is probably the most essential thing in my personal research. I often talk to people who are artists, people who are creatives outside of medical field, and I find inspiration in what they have to say about the projects that I'm working on.
So because here we cannot put the EBUS because the EBUS is always up, right? The echo probably is like up, so we cannot see like here from here.
I'm gonna do what Nick suggested. I'm gonna make samples with different concentrations of carbon or graphite, and we'll test it. Maybe I make three more then. I make two of the number three and one number two, and then I just put the lymph nodes on it, like side by side.
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah,
this is 5, 10.
I hope that especially physicians who have great ideas will see that they can collaborate with engineers and bring their ideas to life.
I'm gonna start working on the lymph nodes. Yeah. Do you make like four models and then only like two of them work? And then you have to make iterations of that to make sure it's final enough.
I don't think this is a single person endeavor. This is a collective effort. And everything that we're able to do is because of the teams that we work with, because of the people that we're surrounded by, and because of the environment in which we're situated. So
without them, it will not be possible.